We will talk about the Honda generator and batteries in the cold of winter. We bought this Honda EU1000i in August of 2018 for a simple reason that we hopefully never have to use it. We actually did a few times, and we'll talk about that at the end. Welcome to Riskapades. Ursula is the navigator. My name is Dieter, and I'm the wheelman. For the last 6+ years, we did the maintenance every 4 months to make sure that the engine still starts. Today is a good day to do exactly that. It is -6 Celsius now, and we just got the generator out from the unheated garage. Wake up, my little Honda. Hibernation is over. 15 pulls to start the ice-cold engine. That's not too bad. The Honda EU1000i delivers 900 watts, so it will not run most heaters, kettles or tools. However, we can plug in our camping trailer, and that was the reason we bought this generator. The trailer has a WFCO Technologies power controller that runs on 120 volts. Anyway, today we test a 12-volt battery charging option on the generator. This test here is a critical proof of concept for the electrical system in the new camping trailer. This 90-amp battery was in the garage for the last 3 months, and the current charge shows 12.6 volts. The generator comes with a special cable to charge batteries. We keep the cable and several 10-amp spare fuses in a bag. We found out the hard way to keep a few of them around. Some appliances may work fine until they are under heavy load, and this is when the fuse blows. Plug in the cable, connect the plus, and connect the minus. The generator is now running in eco mode. The generator delivers 13.7 volt in eco mode and 14.1 with full speed or eco mode up. That is the voltage as expected and within the range for car batteries. First test completed. The battery charge test was successful. Test number two. We had to verify the AC output voltage from the generator. We connected a ceramic heater that draws about 700 watt. The generator output voltage is on the higher side with 128 volts in eco mode and about the same in eco mode off. Same here. The results are within our expectations. We prefer the voltage to be above 120 volt. Unlike most solar generators that produce below 120 volts. According to the National Electrical Code for Canada and the US, anything from 114 to 126 volt is within the 5% tolerance. This test is successfully closed. We do have a working solution to finish the electrical installation. As I mentioned earlier, this test was important for our new trailer. The skeleton doesn't look very fancy yet, but now we can finalize and order the electrical components. We live and travel in a cold climate, and we know that the battery and generator will perform in the cold. When we travel, we keep the generator on the spare tire rack. We used it to cook breakfast on the Curadori induction plate. We charged the trailer battery in Goose Bay Labrador. We ran the heater in Red Bay Labrador after driving down from the snow-covered coastal mountains. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you out there.